Case 3.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. And please enjoy some quality and poignant acting from the theater troupe, Three Hoes and a S***.
You guys, what happened?
I don't know, but my head hurts.
Mine too. I don't think we even want to remember.
I think it was sexy though.
Let's do it, baby. It's Ludacris featuring Trey Songz. Sex room.
Welcome to my sex room.
Ugh. It's the morning after. We find four, I guess, girlfriends, you know, out in a fancy hotel, and no one remembers what happened the night before. I find it odd that one of them has a goatee.
I know Ludacris gets a lot of girls, but when you are so tired of the way women look that you got to start drawing beards on one of their faces, I need to start asking you about life questions, dude.
It's about to get real X-rated. Can you handle what I'm about to do? But enough about me, let me think, should I be worrying about if I can handle you?
Listen, if I were these girls, the first thing I would do is pop back a couple morning after pills. I hear Ty and Iron, and Lo and Baby. I'm a little worried about kids watching this. Hey, you, single mother, letting this show babysit your kid. Yes, you, precious. Get your kid out of here. Come back in 20 minutes, Degrassi will be on.
Welcome to my sex room.
Hi, welcome to my little sanctuary. You've been looking so good all day and you really got a pretty anxious, babe. Better call your boss, tell him that your daddy's home. Take a couple days off and take it off and leave nothing but your t-shirt and your panties on.
Here's another tip from Auntie Deborah. When someone invites you to their sex room, you should probably say no.
Call my boss and let him know that my daddy's home? Sure. Hi, boss. Hi. Listen, I'm going to be gone for a couple of days. No big deal. Just going to Ludacris's sex room.
Yeah, so no, you're going to need someone to cover for me. I've been invited to Ludacris's sex room.
I was going
to
pretend I was sick, but I thought I would just go for the... You understand. Yeah, okay. So that prevents chafing? Oh, thank you for the tip.
Ludacris, he's that crappy rapper.
Yeah, him. Yeah, and I'm pretty sure he's just going to pound me out all night and tomorrow too. So I might come in Friday, but my mouth will be sore and I won't be able to walk. All right, thanks. That went well.
Damn right, I'm going to get that thing, and I'm going to put my name on it. All night, I'm going to f*** that thing. All state better put a claim on it.
All night, I'm going to f*** that thing. All state better put a claim on that.
That is a bit of a strange insurance policy. I don't know if Allstate would cover that. I'd like to make a claim. I was all night by Ludacris. All right, okay, well, good thing we took out that policy and you said that you'd never use it.
Now really, when you really break it down, isn't a sex room like your bedroom or like just any room in your house, isn't it?
Guys, if he has a sex room, he probably has different kinds of rooms too. Like a crying room, a dying room, and a farting room. Gross! Reserved just for farts? You sure insane! You're insane!
Get ready for blast off. Waterfalls gonna splash off. Might lose around 4 or 5 pounds, so get ready to sweat your ass off.
Lose 4 to 5 pounds in a sex session?
That sounds like the best new diet I've ever heard of. Are you kidding? Next week, Luda will have an infomercial. Sleep with me, lose 4 pounds. What? 4 pounds in a week? That is better than Weight Watchers.
Whatever. Like that's gonna happen, especially with me, because I'm a premature ejaculator. You're lucky to burn off 3 calories, because bam, I am done.
Instead of Weight Watchers, we could call it Fat. Get it? That's never gonna make it to air, but what the hell. My verdict for this video is, ladies, watch your drinks. Seriously.
Of course I have a sex room. All right, it's pretty basic though. I mean, you know, a few slings and an 18-year-old chain to the radiator. You know, nothing crazy.